Hello everyone, I'm David with Softron, and today we're talking about what we're going to be showing at NAB. Now, we have a major announcement, but we're not saying it yet in this video. So if you want to find out what we're going to announce, you can come by the booth at NAB and we can tell you there, or you can subscribe to the channel and you'll get notified when we make that major announcement. In a recent video, I gave you a sneak peek of what's new with Movie Recorder and Multicam Logger. Both of those applications will now have TSL5 support. Now in that video, we also talked about the Mac Mini M4 Pro, and now we have the Mac Studio M3 Ultra. With this new Mac Studio, we could capture 20 HEVC signals and 20 ProRes HQ signals at the same time. So already this machine is very impressive, but now that we have Sonnet, who's just announced their Thunderbolt 5 enclosures, that's going to be really important for the 4K workflows. So that's going to get rid of that two channels of 4K 60 limitation. We could potentially double that. So something like this Mac Studio with the M3 Ultra could potentially do 20 channels of 4K 60. So once we have that new Sonnet chassis, we'll definitely be testing this right away, and we will post the numbers on this channel. So make sure you subscribe. Let's talk about a major new feature coming to on-the-air video that we're going to be showing at NAB for the first time. Is HDR video output in on-the-air video. This has been a long-requested feature for event spaces like auditoriums, arenas, and theaters, and so now you're going to have that high dynamic range video output from on-the-air video. It's really just another notch in on-the-air video's belt, considering it is a 4K, 8K, and now an HDR playback solution. Now, I gave a sneak peek of this in the last video, but the dynamic graphics overlay interface has been completely redesigned. Now you have full control of all the graphics and a lot more flexibility. Now this does include a whole new squeezeback engine called SuperSource. And what I really like about this is it's going to take things like your lower thirds and bugs and squeeze those all back. You're also not limited to one design of squeezeback. I can easily stop one and start another. Like this one, that could be great for sports standings and potential advertisement space. You can even run multiple squeezebacks at the same time. So let's say we have our stocks and weather data on air, we can respond to a breaking news event with another squeezeback, and that's going to push back our program to show what is happening. We can even add in another graphic with our new customizable QR code layer on top. The squeezeback and the QR code are just some of the new graphic abilities in on-the-air video. When designing a CG project, we also have options for image resizing, or audio file settings like loop and timing options. There's even a new blur layer, and you can take this and add it to your graphic and even adjust the intensity. Graphic artists can even experiment with the full catalog of effects available in the engine's API. I really like being able to add a black and white filter over video and not having to re-edit said video. Or I can do something like colorizing a video background layer and add a blur to make it look more dynamic. This version of on-the-air video has a lot more improvements than just graphics. There are major changes to the actions, and let's start with the actions window. The new actions window is categorized so you can get to the actions you need faster. There's even new bit focus buttons in there, like controlling a bit focus button, controlling the step you're on, or changing the variable. Additionally, there's an HTTP request, so you can make any type of HTTP request right from on-the-air video. We make the whole experience even better with custom actions. Instead of typing your parameters for every action, the new actions editor allows you to create custom actions you can use via the API or in your playlist. This is going to be great for a lot of things like lower thirds, routing controls, SCUDI triggers, and much, much more. So this update of on-the-air video has a number of wonderful features from HDR, squeezebacks, and the new custom actions. All these new graphical changes to on-the-air video have now come to on-the-air MOS Gateway, meaning you can control your graphics, your projects a lot more dynamically, including right in the plugin. You have options to change the image, the music, and we're actually talking directly to the project now and no longer Apple Script, which makes this a lot easier to use. That means we can get things like your maximum character limits and even movies if that's part of your graphic. So if you come by the booth, we're definitely going to show you in person how this is going to all work together for your newsroom workflow. Now let's switch over to mReplay. Last year, we showed you what it was doing with high frame rate footage, but this year we've added a lot more features that really just help with the quality of life. So let's dive into what's changed. The new multiple playlist feature allows you to efficiently organize clips, making it easier to build show segments like highlights or teases without relying on a single playlist. Another new feature is having multiple export locations. So now you can choose different types of export locations that includes things like what angles should be used, where's the destination, should it overwrite the file? And this gets even more superpowered when you add in the rules. So if a clip is given with a certain name, you can have it exported automatically based off these rules. You can even have it added to a playlist that matches a certain name. In mReplay, we've also added a session restore feature. So if you already made playlists, export locations, and rules you like, you can reuse that in another session. That's going to be very important for those of you doing sports productions with mReplay. So you have a lot of matches and you want to reuse the same rules. You don't have to rebuild it every time. Introducing this year at NAB Streaming Center 2. Now this is going to have the features like RTMP, Facebook, YouTube, and Wowza streaming, but we're adding HLS and MPEG Dash streaming. Streaming Center 2 will be able to handle both simultaneously making those segments. It will also handle adaptive resolution, so you can have that full resolution for something like a TV, but can also have one lower for computers and another one lower for something like a phone. Additionally, it will handle multi-language. The new HLS and MPEG Dash outputs in Streaming Center 2 are going to be a great feature, and we're excited to see how you're going to use it. There's still so much more to talk about what's going to be at NAB, but I really can't fit it all here. So if you're coming to the show, make sure to stop by and see us because there's really so much to cover. If you can't make the show, of course, like I always say, subscribe to the channel and we'll make sure to post everything we can here. For any other questions, you can always go to softron.tv and reach out to us there. Thanks for watching.